Hey Aries, this is your weekly reading for March. Let's go ahead and jump in with each other. Get your spirit number out. Angel number. Get your angel number out here. Aries, hope all of you guys are doing well out there. You're happy, taking care of yourself, working on your happiness, okay? Finding what makes you happy. Get your number out here. You guys. Yes, you are. Your angel number this week here, Aries, is 13. Your positive affirmation is, I am confident here. Okay, your card says you are conscientious. Okay, you are a conscientious worker with a knack for coming up with creative ideas and turning them into million dollar companies, possibly. That's not what it says. Okay, you have a knack for coming up with creative ideas and turning them into something real, okay, and optimistic, okay. But practical outlook keeps you determined and on track as you work steadily towards your goals. They want you to be confident. This number 13 here is the Death card in the Major Arcana. So I definitely feel here, Aries, them telling you that you are a conscientious worker here with a knack for coming up with creative ideas and turning them into something real is very powerful for you guys this week here, okay? I feel like this is gonna call for you guys to leave a lot of things behind that do not serve you any longer, or make some changes, some little tweaks to things that you may be working on right now. And I feel like once you do that, once you make those changes in your life, okay, leave the old behind you and open yourself up to new possibilities here, that you definitely will be able to reach the goals that you are trying to reach. Reach the heights that you are trying to reach here, okay? Your second angel number is 20. Your positive affirmation is, I am harmonious here. For some reason, I'm feeling a little anxiety, I don't know, going into your reading here. I definitely feel like they're wanting you to go cultivate more harmony and balance in your life here. That's the message that they're giving me here, okay? So this could be in a relationship, since we have the number 20 that is coming in towards you. This could be about connections, relationships, partnerships here, either in business or romance here, okay? So your card is saying you realize you relate to others on an almost cosmic level. You are dedicated to building harmonious relationships of all kinds. You have the ability to persuade others to your point of view by using gentle persuasion. No, it doesn't say persuasion. Gentle means. That's what the card is saying. Even though I know you guys use gentle persuasion at times. I know you do. So, Aries, that actually is some really good energy here. But I definitely feel here on the back end that you guys pick your relationships very carefully here. And you also get rid of relationships that you feel aren't genuine. And you don't want to deal with fakeness. Okay. That's what I'm feeling for a lot of you guys here. So relationships and people being honest and truthful here is very important to you guys here. It's crazy all these cards are flipped over. Let's get another shuffle in here. So Aries, you have the last quarter moon in Taurus. Some of you guys have Taurus in your chart. And Spirit is saying, be proud of yourself. Be proud and happy of the accomplishments that you have, what you have accomplished in your life thus far. Okay? Your next card is the last quarter moon in Sagittarius. Some of you guys have Sagittarius in your chart as well. They're wanting you to practice gratitude here this week. So give thanks to the universe for the things that you currently have. And also give thanks to the universe for the things that you have yet to receive. Okay? Because there's more coming. That's what I feel here, okay? Keep working towards your goals here. and be determined to stay on track and stay balanced here. Let's go a little deeper and see what is happening with you guys here this week. What is Aries looking like this week? What does Aries need to be aware of this week, Spirit? Okay. You guys have the Justice card that is showing up for you here, Aries. So some of you guys have Libra in your chart here. They're letting me know, yeah, that you guys are working on balance. And it seems like almost like a process of elimination for some of you guys. Some of you guys are cutting ties to connections that don't serve you anymore. Cutting ties and cutting the cord on people that you don't resonate with, situations that you don't resonate with anymore as well, okay? So I'm definitely feeling this energy here. Some of you guys aren't happy about it, or others aren't happy about it. This Five of Cups is crossing you right now at this moment. So you may hurt some feelings. That's what I'm feeling here, okay? Someone is let down here possibly because you have released them from their friend or lover duties. That's what I'm seeing here. But I feel like some of you guys have to do it, okay? What you need to focus on here, Aries, is the Six of Wands. Definitely this beautiful energy here. Moving from the Five of Wands to the Six of Wands, you've gone through the most. You may have gone through a lot of competitiveness with others here, either in your career or even in your relationships, your personal relationships here, professional and personal here, that you have excelled, okay, far beyond others. So you may not even resonate with their energy the way that you used to. The number 20 here is letting me know that you only want to level up with people who you absolutely have this cosmic energetic connection and vibe with here, okay? It's very important. Your relationships are very important to you, so you definitely pick and choose who you want in your life here to celebrate your accomplishments and to have very close relationships. You have to trust people here, and I feel like that's the relationships that you are focused on this week, because you are excelling, you are evolving very quickly here. That's a message that they want you to know this week, that you guys are evolving. You're going to step into a position of fame, a lot of you guys, good praise, victory over challenges that you guys may have dealt with. A lot of you, this may be dealing with your job here with the Eight of Pentacles. There may be some rewards coming in regards to your finances improving or a position becoming opening up towards you guys here, or you are just becoming more noticed in your career field, whatever you guys are working on here, okay? Whatever it is, Spirit is saying that your hard work is paying off here, okay? You're going to get exactly what you are receiving, and you need to accept it with grace and be and show gratitude here, but also be confident as you move into this new position of fame or progression here in your life. Let's take a look at what is behind you, loves, okay? What is Aries leaving behind? Spirit saying be proud of yourself. Some people may not feel it. They may not be proud. They be like, oh, good job, Aries. I hate that motherfucker. Hate. Hate is real, okay? But we're not going to focus on the hate here. Who's hating on your accomplishments? Spirit is saying be proud of yourself. You have worked for this fame. You have worked for that position. You have worked to be known. You have worked to receive all of the good things that are coming into your life here, okay? You guys have the King of Pentacles here in the past. So this could be someone that you left in the past here, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here. They could have it anywhere in their chart, okay? Some of you guys, I feel like you kind of put yourself some of you guys may have, I wanted to see what the next card was. You have the Hangman coming in here. You put someone on pause, basically. That's what I'm feeling. I feel like you guys put someone on pause here because they did not want you to be the beautiful, bright person that you are here, okay? I feel like someone wanted to dull your shine and you put their ass on pause, okay? With the Hangman and the King of Pentacles that's showing up here, okay? And you went into, I feel like you guys went in a different direction here because you did not want someone to stop your shine, okay? Or threaten what you were trying to accomplish here in your life here, okay? So that wanted to come out here. You guys have the Star card and the Ten of Wands here. You're overcoming challenges. That's what I'm feeling. Ten of Wands, Star card is letting me know that wish fulfillment is coming. Healing is coming into your life. Good luck, money, fame. Okay, fame. Some of you guys are going to be well known out there in these social media platforms, okay, or around your crew or the people that you spend time with here. You're going to be praised and loved and noticed, and a lot of people will look up towards you here. Something big is happening for you guys here this week. You're going to be leaving a period of struggle, either physically or emotionally. I said emotionally, mentally or emotionally or physically, you're leaving a period of struggle here. That's what I'm feeling, okay? So the Star card is definitely coming in as a blessing here, okay? You're transcending from a difficult period into your life, in your life here, Aries, and you're moving towards calmer waters. That's what I'm hearing spirit say at this moment. So let's take a look and see what is coming in the future. For you, what is happening in the future here? Mm-hmm. You guys have the Queen of Wands. Talk about confidence. That's you, okay? Standing in your beauty, standing in your power here, very creative here. And spirit is saying that you guys are very creative here. You're definitely leveling up here. That's what I'm feeling. And stepping into your own creativity here. And I told you, you guys will be very popular or famous, or you're stepping into this energy where you're going to be known by others, and others will be driven by your creativeness here. Again, spirit is saying step into this energy with confidence. Your higher self wants you to know about someone that's in your circle here. Because no, I'm looking through the cards here because nothing else is flipped. So the King of Swords is coming in. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius, possibly. It doesn't have to be. There's someone around you, okay? I feel like that is someone. I don't even feel like that's you here, okay? But they don't like where you're going. They don't like where you're headed. They may not like that you did not choose them or that you have left them behind here. Again, you're choosing your friends very wisely, your relationships, okay? And you're only dealing with people that you can relate with on an almost cosmic level, on a spiritual level here, because you are spiritually evolving here this week and going forward here, okay? So anyone trying to stop that, I do feel they're not going to be happy about it here, okay? So prepare yourself here, Aries. That's what your higher self wants you to know. Prepare yourself for people that may have something to say behind your back. This always gonna happen, okay? Someone's always, you can't please everyone, and nor should you try to do that, okay? Five of Pentacles here, someone will feel like you left them behind. That's the energy that I'm feeling here, okay? What does Aries need to know here for the month, for this week in March? Knight of Pentacles coming in. You're going towards a prize, okay? Towards success in your life here. Usually you see the pinnacle with the guy on the horse looking at that pinnacle, admiring it, very grounded, not hasty, okay? You're very grounded here. That's what I'm feeling with the Knight of Pentacles. You are moving with purpose here, Aries, this week. Okay, so I definitely, and if you don't feel like that, if you feel like your emotions may be all over the place or situations are all over the place, or you may be really busy here this week, know that you need to take periods take periods of downtime for yourself to collect yourself, to bring your energy back in, to ground yourself. So possibly meditate or do some self-care, okay? Go get your feet done or go get a massage or take you a nice hot bath, get you a glass of wine or some beer or a shot or whatever, okay, that you may like, and just chill out and think about where you've been, where you're going, where you are, and plan for your next steps here. They're letting me know that you need to continuously plan for your next steps here, okay? So they're definitely letting me know as well with the Knight of Pentacles that your hard work, again, will definitely pay off. Some of you guys, that's where you need to be at this moment. That's where your focus needs to be, on yourself and what you are working on. Not so much about anyone else here this week. It's all about you, okay? Hopes and fears here. What is Aries' hopes and fears? That you haven't worked hard enough. Stop it. Okay. Seven of Pentacles coming in here towards you. You have. Okay. Continue to invest in yourself. Know that you've done a good job. Spirit is saying be proud of yourself. You've done it. Okay. You've put in the hard work, especially with the Eight of Pentacles coming in. Now you got the Seven of Pentacles. Your fear is that you haven't done enough, but you have. Okay. And I promise you, with the Queen of Wands and the Six of Wands showing up in your beautiful reading here, Aries, that you will have victory over your challenges here, that you will have public recognition, or you will have success moving into your life very soon, this week or over the next several weeks moving into April. I definitely feel like good things will continue to happen in your life, or if you've had a downslide or a down period in your life here, Aries, that things will start to pick up for you here. One important thing to remember, like your card is saying, is to practice gratitude. If you're not grateful for where you are right now and grateful for the things that you have right now in this present moment, how is spirit going to open up new doors when you don't even appreciate what you currently have? So show gratitude, light some candles, and thank your spirit guides. Thank whoever you pray to or whoever you look towards for guidance, okay? And show gratitude for the things that have happened in your life, the challenges that you have been able to overcome, that you're still here kicking and breathing and you're living in another day, and you can go out there and make positive changes in your life. Know that where you are is where you need to be at this moment here. And I definitely feel like spirit is saying continue to invest in yourself, continue to work on yourself, that your efforts will lead to success here, okay? Harvest time is coming for you here, Aries. Look at that. What is this? I'm gonna have to take it the way it just shot out like that, okay? So your final energy coming in here, okay? Look at you. This is crazy. You guys have the Temperance card, okay? Harmony. This is what I was talking about in the beginning of your reading. Harmony and balance is coming into your life, both emotionally, mentally, physically, and spiritually here, okay? Spirit is saying have patience, because I know you, my love. You guys like, it's mine. I want it now, okay? Spirit is wanting you to be patient with yourself. Also, be patient with others that may test your patience. Be patient with them, okay? But also put up healthy boundaries here as well, okay? You're moving towards calmer waters. Like I told you guys, the Six of Swords here. There's a lot of growth happening with you guys mentally and spiritually here. Remember to release any baggage that you may be holding on to in regards to past situations or people here. Accept the lessons that you have learned in your connections. Beautiful things are coming towards you here with the Knight of Cups that is showing up in your reading, and they want you to accept these new beginnings with confidence. Step into the unknown and have faith that you will overcome challenges here. If I can get this to steady. You guys have the Fool card and the Knight of Cups that is showing up. Again, they're talking about your creativity with Knight of Cups. I'm not really feeling love there, okay? I feel like it's all about you and your creative side and your more spiritual side that is going to be, you're going to be focusing more on that this week here, okay? Spirit is just saying follow your heart here with your final messages that are that's coming out, and don't be afraid to take risk. Okay, some of you guys need to be calculated risk. Okay, but don't be afraid to step into the unknown. Woo! Hello, you guys. Your final message coming in. You guys have abundance. Abundance showing up here. Your card is saying you are nurtured, protected, and guided by one of the most powerful deities in Taoism. The time has come to harvest all that you have sown. Didn't I just say this? Continue to follow the path that is yours alone, and you are assured abundance and success in your life. Here, Aries, that is your reading. It's very beautiful. Thank you guys so much for coming back to watch your reading. I do appreciate it. If this message resonated with you, make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Hit that notification bell so you know when I come back to have another reading with you. Okay, and subscribe to the channel if you guys haven't done so already. I'll see you guys later. Bye.